Hi everyone. In this video we are going to see how to use Nessus. So in previous video I have told you how to download Nessus. So what is Nessus, how to download Nessus, how to install Nessus in your system. And now after you have done all these things, now when you log in, so this is the interface you are going to see. So here you can see like our profile. So if I click, so this will show you my account and you can sign out, and this is the setting options. So this is the overview. So last updated on 3rd February and all the details. So activation code and how. So as I told you, the free version will give you 16 IP, so you can scan 16 IPs. So I have used 2 of 16, so I can scan 14 more IPs. So you can check here and license utilization. So like, so what are the, so I have scanned 2 IPs. So what are the IPs I have scanned, on which date, which time. So, and the software update. So if you want to update it, so like if you want to automatic update, if you want to disable automatic update and update frequency, you want to update it daily, weekly, monthly, and all these options. And now here is the master password, so you can choose the master password for more security. And here are some other advanced options. So like there's a lot of, like this is the user interface option, this is the scanning option, logging, so a lot of options. So let's just not go there. So if I click scan, so this is the interface. So I can choose here to make a new scan, or I can choose here to create a new scan. So yeah, I'm clicking here new scan. And once I click new scan, it's going to give me options. So what are the types, which, what are the scan types which I can use? So I can use the basic network scan, host discovery. So it will just do the ping scan. So it will discover live hosts in a network. So live hosts and open ports in a network. So it's just a ping command, the command we use in nmap. So, and for advanced scan, we can use this. So advanced dynamic scan. And you want any malware scan on Windows and Unix system, you can use this. So this is a mobile device scan, but as you can see, it is displaying upgrade, so we cannot use this in free version. And all the like paid scan, so as you can see, upgrade, so we cannot use these because all these are paid. So in the below line you can see, so wherever you see upgrade option, which means this is a paid scan, we cannot use this scan in the free version. So we can use WannaCry ransomware, shadow broker scan, bash shock detection, and a web application test. Here I'm going to use the web application test. So I'm going to test a website, and let me tell you that this test is going to take a lot of time. It depends on the website, so how big the website is, how many directories it have, how many pages it have, and how many links it have. So based on the site, it's going to take a lot of time. So here it is giving us the options. So the general settings, so we can name our scan. So I'm just giving test, so it doesn't matter what you give. So I'm going to leave it blank, and you can create a folder or save your scan inside a particular folder. Like you have to scan websites and networks, and then you can make a folder for websites where you save all your website related scans, and you can make a folder for network scan and where you can save your network related scan. So by default you will have a my scan folder. So I'm going to use this default folder, and here we have to give the target. So I have to give a target. So I'm giving this website certifiedhacker.com, and we can also use this option to add multiple targets if you have a txt file and which contains a lot of websites or a lot of IPs. You can upload a txt file here, and if we look at here credentials, so This is okay, so let's move it here. So if you want to, like, so in our website there will be a like form. So if you want to use default credentials, so whatever credential you will give here, the scan, the Nessus tool will try to log into that page. So this is for that. And these are some plugins. If you want to install some plugins, then you can, yeah, plugin info. So plugin ID and plugin name. So these are the plugins. So web server plugins. And if you go back to settings here, it will give you, like, if you want to schedule your scan. So if you don't want to do it now, you want to do it later. And email recipient. So a notification will send to that email ID that scan has been completed if you want to enable email notification. And if you choose discovery option, so here it is give you, you can select scan type. So if you want to scan all the, like, only the common ports, it will obviously gonna take less time because it's going to use some selected popular ports which are very vulnerable. If you choose all ports, it is going to scan all the 65,535 ports if you want to customize it. So if you want to give it manually, you can use this. So if you look at the assessment, it is working slow. I don't know why. So yeah, this is assessment. So if you want to scan for all web vulnerabilities, so if you want to scan for only known web vulnerabilities, if you want to scan for all web, so this is a complex version, this is a quick version, and if you want to customize it, so as you can see, start crawling from the root folder, root directory, and crawl 1000 pages, traverse 6 directories maximum. So you can always change these options and report. So if you want to, like, generate report, so you can choose these options and advanced. So scan type, so you want low bandwidth links, custom or default. So these are the option. So simultaneously it can host 30 hosts at the same time. So these are the settings. So if we go back to the, like, basic general, yeah, so this was our target, and you have the option to save. So you can directly launch the scan from here. So once you click launch, it is going to scan, or you can, what you can do, you can click here save. Okay, so it is asking me for this, but I'm not gonna, like, use it for this. And if you click here on save option, it is going to save. And yeah, here after you save this, it is, you can launch your scan from here. So just launch the scan from here, and it is going to, like, launch the scan. And you can click on here to see the, scan is ongoing. So as you can see the status, so the scan is running and the start timing. So if you click off one more time, so you will get to see the vulnerabilities if it founds any. So you can see blue means info, low means, like, green, and all the other, so critical means red, so red color means critical. So it only finds one, which is, so which is blue, and blue means info. So it's just for information, it doesn't have any, like, any so you can see the option, so the output. So port number 110 is open in this website, 143 is also open, 2777 port number is open. So these are some port numbers which is open, as you can see. So these are some port number which was found open. So yeah, port 80 and everything else. So yeah, these ports are open, and you can see the risk factor here. So risk factor is none, if you click on host. So yeah, so this is the host, and back to my scans. So it is showing you that it is scanning, and we can see the percentage. So I don't know if you are able to see, it is showing 5%. So currently it only scan 5%. So to be able to do the 100% scan, it is going to take a lot of time. So if I can show you that this is, it only scans 5%. So yeah, so only 5%. So I'm going to stop this because it is going to take a lot of time. And yeah, so that is how you are going to scan any website, or if you want to choose, if you want to scan any host, then you can choose host. Like you can select new scan, and you can choose host, and you can choose any scan type. It depends on your need. So that's it for this video.